إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، أعاذنا الله منها. يقول الله تبارك وتعالى، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، ألف لام ميم، ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين الذين يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون، والذين يؤمنون بما أنزل إليك وما أنزل من قبلك وبالآخرة هم يوقنون، أولئك على هدى من ربهم وأولئك هم المفلحون. Brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us this kitab, Al-Qur'an. And this Qur'an is the ultimate guidance for us, for human beings, for jinn and ins. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created those beings, jinn and ins, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the instructions for worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are in this book. And its explanation in the words and actions and approvals of the Prophet salawatullahi wa salam alayhi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this book to our Prophet salawatullahi wa salam alayhi. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the authority to explain it through his words and sayings, through his actions, and through his approvals. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevated the honor of this book. ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. ذَلِكَ is what they call demonstrative adjective. When you point something, then you say ذَلِكَ if it is far away. Okay? But not only that, also it's used, and this adjective, when you honor something, they say إشارة بعيدة تدل على شرف هذا الكتاب. Okay, so this is an honorable book which we must honor through learning, through memorizing, through understanding the message entailed in it. It's very important. It's not fair that we are Muslims and we come to this country. The first thing we are concerned is how to communicate with the local community, the indigenous community, so that we can get work, so that we can go to universities. But we neglected, really, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we need to come back to it. All of us, irrespective of our ages or our situations, whether you work unemployed, whether you are a child, whether you are young, middle age, or old, we need to come back. We need to fill the mosque, not only for Jum'ah, but for learning Quran, memorizing it, understanding it, and practicing it. ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه. One of the brothers who reverted to Islam said, someone gave me a copy of this book. And then he said, when I opened the book, he said, ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه. And I was shocked. He said, why? Because normally the authors who write books, novels, or any, always say, if I'm right, support me. If I'm wrong, correct me. Okay? Because to err is human. To err means to make mistakes is the nature of human beings. To err is human. But when I opened this book, it says, La Raiba Fi. I was shocked. Who is he who says that I am 100% correct and you need to submit to it? You cannot resist the truth in this book. Then I decided to read from cover to cover until he became Muslim. That seriousness is very important. Not only of us, not only us, but we have to make, we have to spread the book through all human beings. Okay? And to say that, look, you need this book. Wallahi, by Allah, you need this book. You need the guidance in this book. But if he will ask you, do you know it? Have you memorized? No, but. And at that time, that your argument is so weak. So weak. You didn't learn. You don't know anything about it. Okay? So we have to come back to this book. لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين. This book is guidance for those who are muttaqun. Who are the muttaqun? Those who have taqwa. And taqwa is to do whatever Allah wants us to do. Okay? especially those duties that are wajib, obligatory. And also, you have to do substantial amounts of the sunan. And all of them, if you can do all of them, alhamdulillah. But if you can't, do a lot of them. Okay? So that they can you can compensate the pitfalls and drawbacks in the obligatory duties. And then also enjoy life, halal life, but don't indulge too much into it. The ulama used to say, leave a lot of permissible things so that you are able to avoid makruhat and muharramat. Makruhat means detestable. Those things which are despised. They are not haram, haram, but despised by the Sharia. And also the muharramat, prohibitions. You can only do that if you leave gap for yourself between mubah and makruhat. Leave a lot of mubahat, those who are permissible, some of them, so that you will never do the despised things. And then in that way, you protect yourself from doing prohibitions, muharramat. So this is very important. Now, this is the taqwa, to do the do's, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, do this, do this, do this, do this, do this. And you have to do it in order to join the club of al-muttaqun. And also you have to avoid the don'ts. Don't do this, don't do this, don't do this. Full, all this in the Quran and the Sunnah. This is the taqwa. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says this kitab, Al-Quran, is only guidance for those who are al-muttaqun. Those who read the Quran so that they can get guidance. Not those who find some ambiguous things, shubuhat, and then are misconceptions so that you can confuse the minds of the Muslims or the others who may are potential Muslims. There are many people, millions and millions, whose job is to confuse people so that they can deter them Islam, from Islam. Okay? If you read in that kind of spirit, then it's not huda for you. You have to be open-minded, okay? And you have to read Quran in a way that you can benefit from it. Hudan lil muttaqin. So if you wanted to get true guidance, then you have to be one of al-muttaqun. You need taqwa to benefit from the book. That is another thing. Then one more point in this khutbah is to believe in the ghaib. الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. Who are the muttaqun? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in this context, they are the people who believe in the unseen, al-ghayb. Okay? Especially the six articles of faith. Al-Imanu billahi wa malaikatihi wa kutubihi wa rusulihi wa bil yawm al-akhir wa bil qadri khayrihi wa sharrihi. Six. الإيمان بالله is غيب. Allah is غيب. We understand, we sense Him, but we didn't see Him. Okay. وملائكته say, وكتبه. How these books are revealed? The wahi is غيب. Okay. ورسله. Someone comes to us and say that I am the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's ghaib. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us signs that you can differentiate between the real messenger and the imposter. So the one who just claim, like Musaylimatul Kadhab and others. Okay? And then you have to believe in Akhirah, starting from death to the point that human beings will go either to hellfire or Jannah. فَرِيقٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَفَرِيقٌ فِي السَّعِيرِ. This is very important. So we have to believe in the ghaib. Nowadays, we have got a problem. We get pressure from people who don't believe in the ghaib. They say that. And I'm sure they believe a lot of this ghaib. But they don't admit that they believe in it. And in order to destroy the faith of the Muslims, they say that, no. Only science works. Science cannot tell you about ghaib. It can't explain. And be very careful. We have to train our children to say that according to their definition, science, okay, is a very tangible thing. To make a hypothesis, a thinking in something, and then if you get the pattern, then you theorize, you get a theory from your out of your hypothesis. And then the third point is to test it, to experiment it. And if that experiment yields tangible result, which can be repeated by anyone in everywhere in the world, then they declare this is scientific. One of the big lies of the kuffar is to base all the biology on Charles Darwin's theory. They say it is a theory which is not experimented, which cannot be experimented at all. And they say it's scientific. So be very careful. You have to prepare your children to understand the argument, to equip them with the things that they can defend themselves, so that they can rely on this book, so that they can believe in the al-ghayb, in Allah, in the malaika, in the books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the messengers, in akhirah, and in qadr. In qadr, okay? Only those will go to Jannah. They are fariqun fil jannah. Everybody who rejects these things, then will go to hellfire. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us those who believe in everything in the Quran, practice out of sincerity, and also with ittiba' to follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how to practice it. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. ولا تكونوا كالذين نسوا الله فأنساهم أنفسهم أولئك هم الفاسقون. لا يستوي أصحاب النار وأصحاب الجنة أصحاب الجنة هم الفائزون. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك الرؤوف الرحيم. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. ربنا اصرف عنا عذاب جهنم إن عذابها كان غراما إنها ساءت مستقرا ومقاما. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. ربنا لا تجعلنا فتنة للقوم الظالمين ونجنا برحمتك من القوم الكافرين. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية في الدنيا والآخرة. اللهم إنا نسألك العفو والعافية في ديننا ودنيانا وأهلنا وأموالنا. اللهم استر عوراتنا وآمن روعاتنا. اللهم احفظنا من بين أيدينا ومن خلفنا وعن أيماننا وعن شمائلنا ومن فوقنا ونعوذ بعظمتك أن نغتال من تحتنا. وأقم الصلاة.